I'm Nikisa, and this is Munchies Supreme. Today I'm here with Toke and Tia.
And we're gonna rate 7-Eleven Long Beach. Woo!
So many options. So many. Watchamacallits. Wait, that's really what the name is? Hey, Kisa and Tina here. We just got back from 7-Eleven for episode 2. We just finished smoking our pre-ritual joint, which was Black Haze from Legacy Strains. We rolled it up nicely in a Swisher Sweet. Which was grape flavored. I would say it was actually a pretty good partner, right? We didn't even think about it, and I really liked it. It's a very, you know, happy and like giddy feeling.
Giggity, so, giggity, giggity.
I would say that I'm feeling it a little bit more than you, and that's only because I smoked a little bit more.
She did.
and so because of that, I'm really feeling those munchies today. I'm ready to just dive in.
I'm ready. So let's get started with our Slurpees. Because who goes to 7-Eleven and doesn't get a Slurpee?
It's like not us, right? That's for sure.
Never. And back on track to the biodegradable no straw ban, we found these Sour Punch straws at 7-Eleven. They're right next to the Slurpee machine. Sugar just went everywhere, but I don't mind. So I got a cherry flavor.
I've got this before because you were so much better at opening that than I was. There we go. And I got blue raspberry to go with my delicious blue raspberry and Coca-Cola Slurpee.
And I got blue raspberry and cherry. I don't think I've ever tried a Coca-Cola Slurpee before. So I'm really excited to try it.
Yeah.
Because I do love Coca-Cola. So.
I thought you were going to get a Coke and cherry Slurpee, honestly.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've never tried it. Okay. I think it just scares me.
Mm-mm. Oh, this is good.
Ooh, that's really
good. Very nice.
I feel like my blue raspberry straw helps bring out the blue raspberry Slurpee.
No, it really does, because my cherry is just making, like, it tastes more cherry.
You can try my Slurpee. I will not try yours because it's cherry, and if you guys tuned into the first episode, I'm not that big of a fan of cherry myself.
Well, that's really interesting.
Yeah, right?
I don't know, like, okay, it's a Slurpee, so it definitely doesn't have carbonation, but it tastes like it has carbonation.
Mm-hmm.
Say what?
So, I know you don't like cherry, but are you down to try my
All right.
Okay.
Oh, man.
Because sharing is caring.
Aww. It is. Okay.
Ooh, that's good.
I would say a cherry straw is not as bad as a cherry Slurpee.
Right?
So, that's fine. What'd you score your straw?
My straw would probably be, I would say, an 80?
80?
Yeah, let's go with 80. Because you can eat it after. It's candy.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah. No, I agree.
What about you?
80. 80? Definitely above average because it's eatable and functional as a straw.
Right? It's 2-in-1.
Mm.
Okay, so next we are going to do my first pick, which is M&M's. And not just regular M&M's, they are the crispy M&M's. I have something about crunch that I'm just obsessed with. So. Yeah.
And, like, honestly, I'm surprised that you didn't choose, like, you know, a peanut or, like, an almond that's, like, the normal type of crispy crunch. Really excited to see that you grabbed the crispy because those are, like, my favorite M&M, the crispy.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Did you, like, get them, like, back when you were younger? I feel they used to be, like, blue or something. Did you remember they used to be
blue? No,
like,
they were.
Blue,
and
right?
The bag was blue too, right?
Yeah,
okay.
Okay, cool. I'm not tripping.
We're on the same page.
Not tripping.
Yeah, I couldn't. She had helped me out.
I know. I'm having some problems. All right. I had to use scissors. We're human, you know.
So good.
Okay. I love these.
Right? Why did I see one? What's wrong with you? Okay. So on a scale of 0 to 100, these are totally like 95.
For sure. And I feel like when you get them in summer, they're even like a little bit better because the chocolate's a little bit melted. And so you just really get that like nice crispy, just like,
Okay.
Okay. That was delicious. Now I want to share with you my favorite chocolate bar from my childhood. It's called Watchamacallits.
Oh my god, when we're in 7-Eleven, she's like, I got Watchamacallits. And I was like, oh. I was like, what is it called? And she's like, it's called Watchamacallits.
So really funny story, actually. When I was little, my dad had come home when this, like, first came out. And he was like, oh, sweetie, I got you a Watchamacallits. And I was like, what'd you get me, Dad? A Watchamacallits. Dad, what did you get me? A Watchamacallits. Yeah, really funny. Thanks for the dad joke, Dad.
How can you buy and not know what it is?
Yeah, right? But this thing is amazing. I feel like it's like all the good chocolate bars in one. So it's made with chocolate, peanut flavored crisp, and caramel.
It's crunchy.
Yeah.
That's a win.
For sure. So let me open this guy up. It's kind of like, I don't even know how to explain it, but half.
Thank you.
And you can see it's like crispy inside. So it's kind of like a Twix, but like with like little crispy, like crunch type crisp. Yeah. My favorite. My favorite.
Damn, that's bomb.
Right? And I've only been able to find this at 7-Eleven. So really? I'm so glad that we did a 7-Eleven run today.
I'm surprised I've never had this before.
Mm-hmm.
What is wrong with me?
I don't know.
So, you're welcome. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. That's what this show's about, right? Showing you the best munchies to eat while you're high?
Exactly. I'm going to call these 100.
Holy shit.
Hundo.
Hundo.
For sure. I know I gave Twix 100, but I mean, this is Twix next level. So 110.
So next, what I've been talking about for like weeks, because I'm obsessed.
Oh yeah,
Warheads.
Woo! I'm excited.
Damn. And not only Warheads, but extreme sour. All
right, what is this?
So, absolutely. I have a proposition. You want to see how many you can eat at once?
Okay. Can they not be cherry?
I mean, okay, they have a black cherry.
Oh, flavor. That's right. I do like the Warheads black cherry flavor. Okay.
Wow, I felt like there was gonna be more.
That's what she said.
Okay, being greedy. Sorry.
But I mean, okay. How much was it? It was $179. So
that's a pretty good deal. Everything at 7-Eleven was like $1 or $2.
Yeah, so. And then you know when I scanned my app, I got that
free Slurpee. Ooh. Okay. 7 free Slurpee.
Okay.
What?
Are you gonna start? Are you gonna like?
Okay, I'll start.
Okay.
I'm gonna start with blue raspberry. Is this smart to do like one by one or like?
Like, should we do like the same one?
Yeah.
Like you do it and
okay,
I do
okay.
it?
Okay, yeah. At the same time? Or do you want me to start?
Oh, okay. Are we gonna see who cannot be sour face?
Yeah.
Okay.
Should we do that? Okay.
Okay.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna go for a second one.
Oh, a second one. Damn, girl.
Okay. Now watermelon. I'm having issues like opening everything today.
Oh my god. Okay.
What does that mean?
Three. Three is the limit for me.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Okay, three's the limit for me. I can. If you need to, I'm not mad if you spit in there too.
I think I'm gonna do one more.
No, like good. And lemon. Yeah. Oh my god, Nikita. You're the queen of sour.
I can't open it. Oh
god. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You got it. Another one?
No. Okay.
Black cherry. Hey, one of every flavor, Nikisa.
Okay.
Oh my god. It's getting near dawn. Good job. I feel like I told you. All right. Well, glad that challenge is over. And I need to give love to my taste buds. That was like kind of rough. So you want some ice cream? I do.
Yeah, I'm sweating.
Ben and Jerry's half baked. Of course.
Because you can't get any other ice cream than half baked.
Right. Okay.
Why? Because we're baked.
Alright, so I would say that if you're gonna buy Ben & Jerry's Half Baked, maybe don't buy it at 7-Eleven because it was $5.99 for this little pint.
Is it really like that?
I don't think it's that much, right? Like, I don't think it's supposed to be $6. But here's this. And I got you a spoon.
Well, thank you.
And let's dig in. Ooh, look at that brownie piece right there.
Ooh.
Chocolate and vanilla ice cream mixed with gobs of chocolate chip cookie dough and fudge brownies.
That is so good. Dang.
That is like the ice cream that you have to get whenever you have the munchies.
You know that like weird thing you get on your tongue, like when you eat too much sour candy, it kind of like hurts? This helped a lot.
Yeah, right. Oh my gosh, that was gnarly.
That
I'm
was
so
a
glad
great choice.
That we have this ice cream.
Thank you.
Because that was rough, Nikisa.
That was, I'm not gonna lie.
It was fun, but check that, been there, done that, never need to hear it again.
So on a scale of 0 to 100, what would you rate Warhead? Okay, without doing a challenge.
Normally, I would give Warhead like a 70. Three Warheads at once is like zero. No, never, don't.
Yeah, mine would be like 75. Mm-hmm. And then, personally, for this, I'm gonna go 100.
Holy shit.
I think that we picked a lot of good munchies today.
Yeah, I agree. So, on that note, we're gonna, you know, finish this. So, see you later. Tune in to our next Munchies Supreme with Token Tina.
Bye.